Every year, some idiot comes up with a list of most corrupt nations, and Afghanistan is always on top. Here's a country that, by all conservative estimates, has had some say $2.7 trillion pumped into that country. On the issue of, well, the benefits not really trickling down to the population after 15 years of continuous pumping of enormous quantities of money. Yes, sir, I've seen that. And there's a lot of reasons. The first, in my mind, the first person I would hold responsible for this are the donors themselves. This was a highly politicized intervention, and the donors wanted enormous pressure to disperse of a lot of funding. And they did that through most often local NGOs, who are basically proxies of a handful of warlords and very powerful Afghani, who have historically, for the last 30 years, held the population to ransom. So dispersing that amount of money without any mechanism to follow through, having a mechanism to see if what the funds were allocated have actually materialized. I mean, this is a responsibility of those who give the money as well. And at least two U.S. construction companies have been taken to court in the U.S. for building substandard schools that are falling on children. So there are all these great buildings, and the kids are outside the building under the mango tree because they are afraid to go and work inside. So yes. A lot has been wasted, and of course, as usual, it's the person on the street who has suffered the loss, who would still be freezing in the winter and who still would possibly deliver a child at home because there's no MCH coverage.